Muslims can be proud of Omar and Talib in the U.S. Congress. And it says the Muslim world can be proud of the most courageous. And I know, Barry, most courageous and quite possibly with tremendous luck and time, the most effective. Oh, my Lord. Goodness gracious. U.S. congressional representative in years may turn out to be Ilhan Omar, who won election from the District of Minnesota last November, and is all about remarkable courage and something that even her detractors must eventually recognize, as it's human nature to recognize real courage when it's so evident. Barry, I I'm tripping over the words because I can't believe it. What in the world are they talking about? Barry, what kind of courage does she have? Please inform me.
Well, she's a hater, and as we talked about a minute ago when I mentioned that article, mm-hmm. Iran puts on missiles every day, death to America, death to Israel, and promises to destroy Israel. There's a doomsday clock in Tehran that shows how many days, hours, and minutes until the Ayatollah has predicted that Israel will be literally just a pile of radioactive waste. It's not a secret, it's a promise. And Israel is referred to as the little Satan, the United States as the big Satan or Satan, and in their religion, you are to wage holy war until those representatives of Satan are destroyed. So Tehran is our enemy. They preach it every day. And if the friend of your enemy, in this case Ilhan Omar, is also preaching against the United States, maybe, just maybe, Jermaine, people ought to wake up.
I really do hope so, Barry, but I want to go ahead and show you and the crowd an article. It says David Duke heaps praise on Omar, most important member of Congress. All right, and it says David Duke praised Ilhan Omar last week for her attacks on Israel and its supporters, which have been widely construed as anti-Semitic by both sides of the political aisle. Duke, a former KKK Grand Wizard and Louisiana congressman known to most as a neo-Nazi, said in March 7th podcast posted on his website that he was elated by the focus on the Jewish power and the Jewish elite brought on by Omar. Now, what do you think about this nonsense with Ilhan Omar spewing this rhetoric? Would you say that she is unlikely doing the job of David Duke?
Well, it's clear, you know, it's the same as we talked about a few minutes ago, Jermaine. If Iran, which hates America, says you're great, if David Duke, who says the government of the United States must be overthrown, likes you, wow, you've got some strange bedfellows. If Louis Farrakhan, who wants to destroy the government of America and overthrow it, says you're great, now you're really scaring me. And you know what's curious, and I want to segue into the next thought in the next article we've got, which is you've got all these people taking her literally, meaning she knows she's very well educated, she's very well spoken, she knows exactly what she says when she says it, and everybody's quoting her, and she responds basically affirming what she said. So you've got anti-Semites, you've got radical Islamists, you've got David Duke, you know, Ku Klux Klan and neo-Nazi, you've got the haters in Iran, you've got Louis Farrakhan all supporting you. And what does Nancy Pelosi do? Nancy Pelosi, as Speaker of the House, is the most powerful Democrat in Washington. She's third in line to be President of the United States in case of emergency to the President. Scary. And the Vice President. She would be president. And initially, when these quotes from Ilhan Omar started circulating, Jermaine, she came out and said, There will be an apology, and there will be a resolution condemning anti-Semitism. We must seek it out wherever it is. So she started out saying exactly what she should have said. And then, after the pushback from the left wing, crazy wing, I call it, of the Progressive Democrat Socialist Party, she changed. And she made a speech that is so shocking, where she said, obviously, Ilhan Omar is not anti-Semitic. She comes from Somalia. She just doesn't know what those words mean. In other words, she's ignorant of the English language, and everything else she says, highly articulately, very easy to understand, totally translatable for a highly educated young woman. When she speaks about anti-Semitic things, it's just because she doesn't understand the words she uses. Now, when you read the transcripts, none of them are, as they used to say, big highfalutin words, Germaine. They're regular terms that are very common in the everyday vernacular. So even Nancy Pelosi, the head of the what you'd call the middle of the road Democrats, cannot condemn this horrible, I mean this literally, horrific anti-Semitic language. She apologized for Ilhan Omar, not saying she's sorry for what she said, but whatever she said, which might have been bad, was simply because she doesn't understand the words. Oh my gosh. I'm stunned by the lack of courage and the integrity, or I should say lack thereof, of the Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi. And as a result, what actually got implemented was worthless after all this aggravation.